And ladies and gentlemen, we are back for our semifinals. You okay there, Gary?
Yes, I'm fine.
Alright, great. Because once again, it'll be me, Akliff.
And me, Gary Young.
We'll be commentating this time the top four semifinals for the 2018 mid-season showdown here at 25C Arts and Hobbies. So, for our top four, we saw just now...
Akil and Stephen Tan.
Akil versus Stephen Tan, where Akil managed to pull through from a 0-1 deficit.
Yes, he really adjusted very well throughout the whole game.
Correct. So now we have on our first semifinals for top four, we have JSDO versus
Lim Xiao Tang.
So these both players are actually quite new in the scene.
Yes, actually, in fact, it's my first time seeing their names in the top cut.
Correct.
And even in the circuit as well.
It really goes to show that, you know, in Pokemon, anyone can win.
Yes, as long as you put your effort.
And, you know, a little bit of luck thrown here and there.
Yeah.
That's just how Pokemon works.
Yeah, that's how Pokemon works, definitely.
So, okay, we can see already a bit of the team preview on the side. JSDO
on the left side
here is carrying a very interesting team with Latias, Landorus T, Aegislash, Tyranitar, Tapu Fini, and Kartana.
So on Xiao Teng's side, we'll see the Incineroar, Metagross, Tyranitar, Tapu Fini, Landorus, Terraform, and Zapdos. So for both players, are a very standard team.
Standard teams other than probably the Incineroar and the Latias here?
The Latias is actually a very interesting pick.
Very interesting. So we know that, actually for both teams right now, it's very possible that they might be carrying double Megas, one with Mega Latias and Mega Tyranitar, and for
Xiao Teng,
he's probably gonna be a Mega Metagross is confirmed.
Yes.
But whether or not it'll be a Mega Tyranitar is a possibility.
Yes. I ran that team before. Actually, double Mega, even bringing Tyranitar, actually works well even without a Mega Stone.
Correct, because Tyranitar doesn't necessarily need Mega Stone because it works very, very well on its own.
Yes, it's a very, very flexible Pokemon, and we see how both players actually got into the top four with both Tyranitars.
Actually playing like both of them, Landorus Fini. You can see the Landorus Fini and Tyranitar.
Yeah.
Tyranitar, this one, and like a steel type in both Aegislash and the Mega Metagross.
Yes,
possibly,
and then,
possibly.
Yeah. So it really depends on how both players play around. And just now we saw Xiao Teng, he actually decided very quickly. He knows what he has.
Yeah, I think Xiao Teng here, his Incineroar might be doing a lot of work, especially against the Latias and the
Aegislash. Even against Kartana.
Incineroar Zapdos lead.
Yeah, and I believe just previously in the Swiss, actually JSDO and Xiao Teng actually fought one round. So they actually,
really?
Yes, they already fought. So
interesting.
They pretty much know each other's sets already.
So this is the vengeance match.
Yes, it's gonna be a vengeance match. Previously, was Xiao Teng actually took the game.
So here Kartana can actually, if he goes for the very interesting new Z Tailwind, it's been popularized because it makes Kartana into a crit machine.
Yes, a crit machine that almost an unstoppable crit machine. However, against Zapdos and Incineroar, I don't think Kartana can actually.
A bit harder, but what we expected is actually a fake out and a tailwind.
Yeah, a fake out tailwind on the shouting side is actually extremely
very safe. Easy.
Oh, actually fake out on the lander.
Yeah,
so
I think that's a very obvious play.
Yeah,
there's nothing to fear from the Kartana.
Yeah, because Kartana, Incineroar and Zapdos actually walls both of its stats.
Correct, and only the Landorus poses a threat, but then Rock Slide. The flinches, I guess, would be annoying.
Yeah, perhaps he just needed a guaranteed tailwind setup regardless.
Yeah,
of course, JSDO played a little bit too safe. He could have gotten for a tailwind, potentially. And perhaps he can at least even up the games.
I guess he was really afraid of losing his Kartana.
Yeah, because you're talking about Kartana standing in front of an Incineroar or Fire-type, as well as a Zapdos who potentially carries Heatwave.
But the tailwind on this turn was quite obvious to see.
Yeah, it was kind of obvious.
Maybe for us, I guess.
Yeah.
But for them, who knows what goes through the minds of top players.
Yeah. Then of course Xiao Teng does now is in a extremely commanding position. He can just fire off attacks left and right. Nothing at the back actually wants to switch into heavy attack.
I suppose it does. It reduces the damage of Heat Wave.
Yeah.
Due to Sandstar giving him an extra special defense.
Yeah, and I believe he can take a.
But you're going for
hidden
a
power.
Classic hidden power ice. Not doing much. Maybe it's an assault vest.
Yes, he's taking the hidden power ice very well. Of course, he's going for Flare Blitz onto the resistor Tyranitar. Hopefully it doesn't catch a burn.
Not doing much. Rock Tomb instead.
Yeah, I think he's trying to control the speed both ways. You can go for a tailwind, I can just continue go out for my Rock Tomb. We're just trying to even the scales.
I guess, but here we can see that Zapdos can easily go for another hidden power.
I think Landorus isn't really a good spot standing there any longer.
Not exactly in the best position, that's for sure.
And then either I don't think Katana wants to switch in thanks to his paper thin special defenses.
But like I think Landorus really. Oh, actually no. Maybe going into Latias because. Tapu Fini. Fair enough.
He can take a hidden power.
He can take both attacks from.
Yes, of course we're not sure what could the Terminator do. Would he go for a potential Dragon Dance? He could be going for Rock Slide.
Rock Slide, I think it's fair.
GSDU actually helped out Xiao Ting.
So he's going into his own Landorus. Very smart here. Now he will cut the damage of any potential Rock Slides.
Yeah.
Thanks to the Intimidate.
Yep, and the Intimidate actually, that's why Landorus is so popular in the usage.
Yeah, so. Ooh, actually calling the predict into the
Thunderbolt.
Okay, never mind.
You just need to get as much damage as he can onto the Thunderbolt.
True. Well, he can just Thunderbolt into the Fini anyways.
Yeah, but thanks to his minus one, Zapdos actually takes the hit quite comfortably well.
Yeah, and like usually like they can carry also a Roost to just heal up even more.
Yeah. Well, of course now when Fini is still isn't really in a bad position. Of course, there is a threat of Thunderbolt, but he's still...
Yeah, it won't KO.
It won't KO, but
I mean,
then again...
Possibly an Earthquake and... Earthquake and Thunderbolt.
Yes,
potentially.
Yes, he just. I think at this rate, Xiao Ting just had to go for the full offense. There's no.
Could be, but now here's the thing. The GSDO could just switch out.
Yes, he could switch out the Landorus, cutting each attack, cutting its attack while taking the immunity of attacks.
We saw it. So whether or not Xiao Ting calls this.
Yeah, if he actually goes for Hidden Power Eyes onto the Tapu Fini slot, it's going to be extremely good.
It's going to be like really quite epic right there.
He's going to be reading like his opponent like a book. So you had to go for an Earthquake.
It's a very safe play anyway.
Yeah, there's not much reason to deviate from an Earthquake.
Because at least you hit the Tyranta.
Yeah.
I don't know if it'll KO, but you know, it'll do substantial amount.
He actually does.
Just looking it out thanks to the Intimidate.
Yeah, and it's a weakness policy.
Interesting.
Very interesting, and definitely Zapdos isn't one who's staying long. Oh, it's a Rock Slide, so we're not sure if Zapdos can actually take a plus one.
But I don't think it will.
It doesn't take at all.
It's very hard for Zapdos to live through that.
Yes, because of that, he actually denied any future tailwind.
GSD were playing some 200 IQ calculated tactics right now.
Yes, perhaps he already knew that he would actually leave the Thunderbolt.
But now, going to his own Tapu Fini, we're just gonna give it a very simple cleanup.
Yeah,
from,
it's gonna.
And I think a Rock Slide from Landorus and a Muddy Water.
Yeah, he has to go for that play. Even whatever situation, doesn't like to take a Muddy Water nor a Earthquake. But then again, we're not sure if the Landorus actually scarfed. If he is scarfed, then Fini could be open to get hit by its own Earthquake.
Yep. I think Rock Slide.
Yeah, yes. But of course, if your Landorus is locked in the choice scarf, then...
Could be. It's a possibility.
Yeah, but let us... it feeds our eyes. Because at any rate, I think Tyranitar can't really stay long in the field because of remaining HP.
I mean, but like, it'll be best for him to just sack it, honestly.
Yes, it'll be a miracle if he can still land a Rock Slide.
I think, like, the Tyranitar on JSDO should just be sacked.
He actually switches our Landorus Incineroar, so...
Okay.
But now we're
not... I guess because he has Tailwind on his side, so...
Yeah, yes, he has Tailwind on... No, the Tailwind is already petered out, so he has to switch out his Landorus.
Strange choices.
Yeah,
actually, Tapu Fini going faster. Because it's Assault Vested.
No. Yeah, but Assault Vested, but yet, its base defense is actually a lot... Space speed is a lot higher, so...
Base
91 against base 85. Whereas this Tapu Fini is very invested in speed.
Quite invested. It's probably quite a bit of investment, if I would say so myself.
Yeah, and given that how it took the HP ice from Zapdos like a champ...
It's pretty obvious that it's an Assault Vest.
Yeah.
Because like, you can't just simply take times 4 weaknesses like that.
Yeah, of course now Katana comes in. Of course, standing in front against an Incineroar isn't really good for Katana.
Possibly not, but if he has the Sacred Sword, he can just take it out.
Yeah, he can just take it out, and we're not sure what the Fini actually has, because given it...
I mean, Fini's just gonna drop, like,
Muddy Water. Maybe hope for special defense draw.
Accuracy drops.
Accuracy drops, my bad. So, of course, I think the fake card is pretty much obvious. Perhaps
Katana going for a protect. I think this is also pretty much obvious. This is pretty obvious.
Yeah, too obvious. Of course, there's no reason for Fini to protect because he can take both. Oh, and Fini actually avoids it and lands a Skull.
A bit unfortunate.
Yeah, and there goes to Incineroar. I think pretty
down,
much.
Yeah.
Down. I think that was the main threat.
If not, his Zapdos with potentially Heat Wave would have been the answer to Katana. Now the Katana is pretty much running free.
Yeah, and of course, he is minus one, but I don't think of Fini actually.
It does not, okay, here's the thing. It doesn't really matter now. Yeah. Because he can just go for a Leafly on any.
Any.
Or let's say Landorus. It KOs Landorus. It gets a Beast Boost. And then it KOs Fini.
Yes. Of course. We're not sure what can a Fini actually do. But you can still land Muddy Water or two, but... We may be able to live, we're not sure about this, but let's not forget, JSDO has another Fini on his side.
Yeah, and like this Fini is easily gonna take some damage up its...
Yes, it can go for Kama.
Well, up its shell, yeah.
It can go for Kama, it can go for Moonblast just to reduce Tapu Fini's damage, who knows.
True, but actually going for a switch out instead, not willing to take any sort of damage here.
Yeah,
coming in with another Tyranitar, reset that Sandstorm,
yeah,
and just gonna die.
Yeah, I think he just wanna set a Tyranitar, bringing up the sand so that Tapu Fini gets whatever cheap damage it has. Well, of course, the katana's
not really the best in my opinion.
Yeah, of course.
Given that it actually outspent the Landorus, and the katana, could mean that it's scarf.
Yeah, it could be. It is scarf.
Actually,
and
going
for Leaf Blade onto the Tapu Fini.
That's some high IQ plays right there.
Yeah,
because I did not expect. I really expected the best play for him just to go into the Landorus.
Yes,
seeing as how low HP it had.
Yeah, I mean if he can get into the Landorus, he can just get a free Leaf. He get a free Beast Boost.
Yeah.
Then he could. Take down the Fini for free.
Correct. At neutral, all Kartanas at 252 attack should be able to KO.
Yes. But regardless, I believe JSTO doesn't mind at all because Fini is still on the field. He can easily land Muddy Water to chip down the Landorus.
True. Yeah. If anything, he has called again? Smart Strike. Now's the time for him to do it.
Yes, of course. Now,
just to prevent any accuracy shenanigans.
Yeah, but of course now I think it's still a safe play for Dio JS. He can target the Landorus. He can just target Fini just to chip it down.
Yeah, Fini is better actually. Now at this rate, Fini. But like, if it was a previous turn, then the Lando would have been a better choice.
Yes, it's a better choice. Now at this rate, whoever the JS Dio targets doesn't really matter because Scout is going to take down the Landorus regardless.
Correct. This Rock Slide not going to KO the Kartana.
Nah, not going to KO the Kartana unless
it's Scout. Steel typing.
Yep, and there's no way it's going to get a flinch at all.
No flinches, a bit unfortunate there, going for a Moonblast straight up.
Yeah,
don't want to miss with Muddy Water.
Yep,
JSDO taking game one.
Yep, taking game one comfortably. And of course, we'll see in game two how both players react.
How Xiao Tang will...
Yes, because I think that by now both players have already got their information, even back in Swiss. They already have their information. Perhaps JSDO already knew the scarf Fini.
I didn't see the Latias, so I'm a bit sad.
Yeah, I'm quite interested to see the Latias.
Yeah.
Because we don't know when he can actually
It could be a Mega Latias.
Yeah,
that would be real cool.
Yep, very cool Mega. We see, and come to mention it, we haven't seen Dio actually brought out any of his Mega Evolutions, right?
Yeah, no Megas at all so far in game one. Like
even for both players, we did not see any of their Mega Evolutions.
The Tapus that have been really being the star of the show.
Yeah, and perhaps in the Landorus speed control. So
a little bit of speed control there.
Yeah, neither players actually. In fact, neither of the players actually revealed a Z move, right? Z move nor their Mega Evolutions.
No Z moves seen. No.
I don't recall seeing any Mega Evolutions or...
Yeah, no Mega Scene also.
Yeah, so I'm kind of curious like who is carrying the Z-move or who is actually carrying the items.
It's a bit difficult to tell because... Oh, wait, actually, honestly, now that we look at it... Yeah, his answer seems to be like, unless there's superpower on the Landorus to hit the Kartana, then like... JSDO's Katana can pretty much run through the team.
Yes,
as long as Incineroar is taken out.
Yes, but even then, it's given that the potential Megas in the team, like Mega Latias, Mega Tyranitar, or Mega Metagross, both aren't really good in this matchup because there's a threat of like Aegislash, there's a threat of Incineroar, there's a threat of Landorus. So perhaps they may not be comfortable to bring the Megas.
Metagross would have been the better choice.
But
I mean, at least with the Clear Body, it can take one Intimidate before Mega Evolves.
Yes, perhaps you just need to watch out for the Aegislash matchup.
And it would be a better choice to fight against the Tapu Fini and the Kartana, I guess.
Well,
possible.
Yeah, possible because
better typing at least, I would say.
Yeah, it is a good typing. So, of course, that's why Metagross is actually still running rampant back in VGC 18 compared to VGC 15. And really see Xiao Tang actually decided his team quite fast, of course.
Yeah, he knows. He definitely knows what he thinks he knows what he wants.
Yeah, perhaps he already has a game plan on how he can handle against JSDO's team.
Yep, and JS here going straight up as well. Like, taking a little bit of time to decide, but in the end, like, He knows what he needs to play. He knows that once he gets rid of Tyranitar, his Kartana can easily run through.
Yes, and of course, I think as perhaps we may see a different lead, because I think in teams like this, there's a lot of flexible leads. There's no autopilot mode can go. So we'll see Metagross and Zapdos.
Zapdos, not bad, not a bad lead at all.
Yeah, this could be our first game where we see the Mega Evolution.
Could be. Here is,
Tapu Fini and
what
Kartana.
What will Metagross go for? That is the question here.
Yep, and of course, sadly, since he has revealed, Zapdos has Misty Seed,
that's really my thing.
Yeah, he actually gave the Misty Seed out for free.
Could be, but I don't think for Xiao Teng, he doesn't really care.
Yeah, he doesn't really care.
He's in a bit of an advantageous position here. A little bit.
Yeah, because Metagross actually takes Tapu Fini Seed and Kartana Seed very comfortably well.
It can, but like after a while, after like probably one or two turns, it will probably not want to.
Yeah.
Because if he doesn't KO in return, then
I don't think Tapu Fini likes to take an Iron Head, which could potentially age.
Now, the question is whether the Fini switch out into a Landorus and take an Iron Head to the face.
Just hopefully Dio actually remembers that Intimidate doesn't work right now.
That's right. Because right now, a double up into the Fino actually makes a lot of sense.
Yes. There's no one reason for Zapdos to go for a Tailwind.
Ooh.
That's all actually. Finally, we see our Mega Evolutions in our
Protects coming in
finals.
Wait, there could be a Protect after this.
It could be a Protect, but it depends who's trying to play safe.
But no switch outs, that's what I was saying.
There's no switch out. Oh, and Kartana actually reveals we have Tailwind.
Interesting. Not even Z Tailwind, just normal Tailwind.
Normal Tailwind. So we're not sure. Are they trying to match Tailwinds? Of course, now it's. Whoa, that's taking a lot of damage.
Wow, was that an Iron Head?
Yep, there is an Iron Head. Plus a Thunderbolt.
Ouch.
Shaking up the Tapu Fini.
Capital OUCH. Ouch.
Yep, never mess with the power of the Mega Metagross.
Those tough claws, man.
Yes, but this is not. This actually helps a duo, JS duo more than it.
Yeah, that is a free switch in.
Yeah, it could be a free switch to the Landorus, I guess.
Lando is the best choice.
Yeah, Lando is the best choice. You can just go for. He can just go for any attacks he wants. Oh, Tyranitar comes in.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Tyranitar.
I guess so. I guess it's a good idea. It's a good check to the. To the Metagross also.
Yes, of course. Against a Metagross, without the Tailwind, it's gonna be quite hard for Dio. It's gonna be quite hard for Xiao Teng, to be honest. Unless he gets his Tailwind out.
Xiao Teng here still can do a few things.
Yeah,
I think the Protect on Metagross here is really good.
Yeah, I think a safe Protect Tailwind is pretty much his only out.
You know, he just Protects and then Thunderbolts with Zapdos. Actually, no Protects coming in from
Sacred Sword, yeah.
Sacred Sword, okay.
Onto the Metagross.
Chunking it.
Oh, so I believe he's trying to guarantee the knockout. And Metagross actually lives.
If it was assurance, it would.
Yeah, if it's an assurance, and Metagross like Iron Head sticking
into Tyranitar will definitely take out.
That must be a very bulky Tyranitar.
Interesting.
Yes. However, you're already giving it a weakness policy boost. But Xiao Teng has already got his Tailwind up, so he's really matched the Tailwinds, and he's still at an advantage because Metagross is faster than Kartana, and Zapdos is really faster than Tyranitar.
Correct. But now, like, the Metagross is like really in a precarious position.
Yes,
now the Kartana can easily pick it up and take it.
Yeah, but of course the Metagross can just protect anytime or even switch into
true.
Tapu Fini while taking down the Tyranitar.
But should it? That's the question. Oh, Tyranitar actually going for Protect.
I think it's kind of obvious because
fair.
Any attacks is going to be too obvious.
Still not protecting on the Metagross.
Yes,
wow. Actually outspeeding the Metagross.
Yeah, Metagross has the base speed of 110 while Kartana is 109. So,
how do you outspeed it though?
Yeah, perhaps Xiao Teng's Metagross isn't that fully invested in speed.
Probably.
Yeah, that could be one of the reasons.
That's a good consideration to make.
That could be one of the reasons why you actually lived the crunch and secrets of double target.
I would think that Metagross, especially Mega, they need to have full investment in speed to make the best.
Yeah, I think that's pretty much a selling point. Anyway, you want to outspeed things like Ninetales, Katana, maybe at least speed type with Gengar.
Well, now, honestly, like if he stalls out a turns of Tailwind here,
it doesn't really matter because Xiao Teng has already gotten his Tailwind out.
Yeah, that's why. So
we'll
have to stall against Xiao Teng's. Dio has to stall against Xiao Teng's.
Yeah, I think it's pretty much enough. Now we see that Tyranitar is at a very low health. He's going to be getting attacked by Zapdos anytime. Yes, and Incineroar can just go for a simple fake out onto Kartana. Of course, Landorus can come in anytime.
Yep, true.
Yeah, but he's going to fake out onto Kartana. Perhaps breaking his potential focus sash. And he's going for a hidden power. I think he's trying to read the Landorus switch in.
Yeah, it's a safe move.
It's a safe move regardless. He's going to go down to hidden power ice even if it doesn't switch out.
Correct. Now Lando comes in though.
Yeah, Landorus comes in and then Landorus comes in, but then again, he doesn't really have a face against HP Ice carry. I mean, Zapdos carries HP Ice.
Could be, but like Rockside will still definitely hurt.
Yeah, because it's not intimidated anyway. Yeah, of course. Now I think has the treatment paid out for JS Teo's side?
I think it's the last turn. Already has. I don't know.
Yeah, then it's gonna be then Insura can just go for
very easy flab bits. Yeah. Yes, but here Sacred Sword because the katana actually did carry Sacred Sword. The Incineroar seems to be in a not so good position.
Yeah, not in a good position. Then again, it's not gonna knock it out.
No, it can because it's at plus one.
Oh yeah.
Ouch,
is never. Well, katana is. That's why the katana is still good, back even in VGC 17.
Correct, so.
Yeah, I think he's trying to intimidate, trying to control the damage, whatever he has.
Ooh, going for a detect instead. Okay.
Okay, but we're not sure what would the Landers do. Rock Slide, Earthquake, we have no idea. I don't think we're going to use Earthquake.
No, Rock. Ooh, okay.
Rock Tomb. Onto the Landers.
Okay, well, why?
Well, I think he's trying to chip as much damage as he can on the Zapdos side so that press katana is still outspeed.
Supposing the exchange both the Tailwinds have already beat it out.
Yeah,
so now he can be faster than the Incineroar.
Yes, but I think Tailwind is still up on Shouting side, right?
No, Shouting.
So both
Tailwinds are out.
Yep, so he's switching out to Landorus.
Zapdos, okay. I see. Yep. I see what he's trying to do.
Yep, will the Flabbits go into the katana again? Because I think there's no reason.
No, katana here was Sacred Sword for sure.
Yeah, but the big concern is whether he can
Rock
actually
slide.
Oh, a rock too onto the Incineroar?
Yeah, Incineroar.
If he knocks out, it's pretty much game.
So it's too bad. Even if he had Rock Slide, he would have done at least some chip damage to the Zapdos.
Yeah,
as well.
But I think maybe he doesn't want to risk any Rock Slide missing due to its accuracy.
Quite shaky, so.
Yeah, but Rock 2 was a safer play regardless.
Yeah. No, actually, I was thinking Rock Slide would have been better anyways because at least you also hit whatever.
Yeah,
and at this rate, you need to make a few big plays and rely a little bit on luck to it.
Yeah, of course, now Shouting isn't really in a good position. We believe that the Zapdos doesn't actually carry Heat Wave. If it does, if you have used it a long time ago.
It's very hard for, I think both sides here like are in quite precarious position, but like with Landorus, with JSDO's Landorus being at -2.
Yes, he won't be doing much damage throughout the whole game.
Yep.
Even for Katana first.
So here, I think right now, like Zapdos could easily just go for another Tailwind.
Yeah, he can go for another Tailwind, just to match up the speed. He actually can take Katana quite comfortably well.
At -2 again, definitely. Another Protect. I really think that the Protects coming from JSDO here are not.
There's a knockoff. Yeah. Removing renderers as
That's an assault vest, so the HP ice will actually
do a lot.
Would probably manage to nab the KO, but
yeah, of course, if we nab the KO at now, it's pretty much over.
Yeah, so that's why I said, like,
oh, you go for Thunderbolt.
Okay.
So if Shouting goes for Tailwind and this turn, actually, it's gonna be very good.
I really think he shouldn't have gone for.
Yeah, I think he should just gone for the Landorus.
Yeah, just go
he should just gone for the Landorus. It's unlikely the Landorus is gonna protect regardless. Yeah,
he needs to make those plays right now.
Yeah. But of course, right now Landorus could still go for big attacks onto the Zapdos. Oh, he eventually goes for against the Landorus.
And still doing a lot of decent damage. Ooh,
yeah, Earthquake. For Earthquake.
I guess because he wants to stack as much damage onto the Katana as possible.
Yes, of course not. I mean, of course, I believe that Teo should just targeted the Zapdos. If you could just leave Blade onto the Zapdos, perhaps he could. And
both actually willing to have Assault Vest.
Yeah, sorry. I believe Assault Vest is getting more popular in our
meta. The ability to survive against special attacks is
very good.
It's a bit important for Landorus.
Yeah, I still think that Duo should just double target the Zapdos. He shouldn't target Landorus.
Possibly, that's one thing. But like, there's nothing that the. We've seen all four moves from the katana already.
Yeah, Leaf Blade, Sacred Sword,
Tailwind, and detect.
Yeah, so he doesn't have any reliable move to damage the Zapdos. Perhaps he should have realized that the Zapdos was actually a big threat.
Correct.
For katana.
Yeah. So, going for an I don't think it was a good idea.
Even if it's okay, I don't think it matters. Yeah, yep, it won't matter at all. He goes for an Earthquake, but a simple Thunderbolt will just knock it out regardless.
Because of the abysmal special defense.
Yes.
He could have gone for the. Actually, never mind.
Yeah. I think both players. Actually, during that turn, it was a 50-50 play regardless. If had one side being played safer.
It could be, that's a possibility.
Yeah, so like we see Shouting actually takes game 2.
So we'll be moving on to game 3 to determine who will be the winner of the semi finals.
Yep, so now, since both players are already tied, they already know that. Both players are already tied in their game matches. They already know each other's information very well. It's going to be very interesting to see how both players maneuver to determine the last winner of the game. Of course, it'll be good if you can see Dio actually brought his Latias around. If he actually carries it. I mean, bring up the matches. Of course, Shao Ting, now that he has really managed to make a comeback, he can actually try to maneuver around against Dio. So it'll be very interesting. This will be a deciding match to see who goes into the finals in this mid-season showdown. And both players are actually just started their team preview. And I believe Shao Ting hasn't been is concentrating, finding out a more suitable way to come around in this position. And as for Dio, he already lost his game. He has to find out another different strategy to counteract against it. So I think Shao Ting has been taking quite some time to think of his matchup. Previously was deciding quite fast in the previous game. So both players, whoever wins this gets to the finals
yep. And potentially take yep. the championship of this MSS.
Yep. So whoever loses goes home. That's for sure.
Oh, that's true. Yeah. Now is the time to go hard or go home.
Yeah.
But I guess it's been that way since the start of the top 8, anyways.
Yeah. You either do big or you go home. That's all. So Shao Ting has already decided his team. Dio is still thinking of his team.
He Shao Ting knows that the Zapdos is going to be the key
was actually lies on Zapdos, so Dio has to take down the Zapdos as fast as he can.
But it's quite hard to see, he keeps looking for Rock Tomb instead of Rock Slide.
But Rock Tomb is actually more painful than Rock Slide.
Yes, but you miss out on the chance of
flinching.
Hitting both targets. Yeah, so flinch is a bonus, not a requirement.
Yes, Incineroar and Zapdos.
Against the Fini, the bad call, but it's a good anti-lead coming here from Shao Ting, a very, very good lead.
Yeah, a good anti-lead.
Having both Zapdos and the Incineroar here could easily take out,
he can use easy go for any. He can go for any super effective move under the Aegis Dash, and Tapu Fini doesn't really like taking a Thunderbolt from it. So I would say Shao Ting has the board positioning very well. Of course, Dio depends on what the Aegis Slash do, but I don't think he likes to take any Flablitz or even Darkest Lariat.
Darkest Lariat, yeah. I think it's a better scope for Darkest Lariat because actually it doesn't really matter, because if he switches into Tyranitar into that slot, it'll take not so effective damage anyways.
Yeah, he may have to switch out into Tyranitar,
but at least with Darkest Lariat, you won't be affected by the stat changes.
Yeah, and Flablitz, you won't get the recoil, it goes for a
top. Oh, interesting.
So it's trying to go for the safe play, fake out, and Tailwind play.
Fair
enough, and we won't.
So with Vinci, so
now it depends on what does the Aegis Slash do.
Will he go for
a Sacred Sword? Wow!
Oh, interesting, revealing itself that Sacred Sword, but leaving a meager 50% to Incineroar.
He's doing very little to the Incineroar. That's sad enough. If it killed, it'd be good, but I don't think it would, man. Yeah, it wouldn't, but
usually like Aegis Slashes are specially invested.
Yeah, I think any damage the duo inflicted is definitely very good, very valuable.
Decent. I would say it's better for it to inflict on the Zapdos, to be honest.
Yeah, he needs to Zapdos to go down here as soon as he can.
Oh, of course, Tyranitar. A good switching from shouting into the Fini as well.
Yeah, Fini is still not really in a bad position. He can still dishes out Muddy Water, Moonblast.
Yep, that's the Aegis Slash is going into his.
Just going to play safe.
No need to, have any flashy plays.
Yeah, there's no need for any flashy plays. Of course, Zapdos going for a Thunderbolt onto the.
Yeah, it's an alright call because he would have thought that the Fini switched into the Landorus.
Yeah, maybe he could be fearing the Landorus switching anyway. But now, Tyranitar is sitting quite in a comfortable position.
Yeah, I mean, we know that he has the weakness policy.
Yeah,
with the Sandstorm, he gets a special defense boost.
Yeah, so Tapu Fini can't exactly use Muddy Water recklessly against a weakness policy.
Oh, actually, this is pretty current. This is a pretty good play.
Yep, Lander as well, trying to reduce any damage Rock Slide can do.
Because here's the thing, if he goes for a Moonblast onto the Tyranitar, it just procs the weakness policy.
Yeah, and Tapu Fini goes for a Taunt.
Revealing the Taunt like
this is huge.
Like, no subs for you today, man. Yes,
no sub, no King Shield, no White Guards.
Yeah, no White Guards, so nothing to stop him from launching off. Easy, easy.
Yep,
he is trying to go for a sub because it saw the opportunity community, but like, oh, chopped it.
Yep, they literally denied,
man. Easy clap here from Chao Teng, man.
Yeah, of course, had Hengist like going for an attack, you'll be vulnerable in blade form.
Correct, yeah. So, but that now, either way, is vulnerable.
Yes, but however, since it was revealed, Fini to have a scarf, he has to switch up.
What did Fini go for?
No, you went for a taunt, and it was revealed it was a scarf.
Yeah, you actually
outspeed Katana and other ones.
Probably a scarf.
Yeah, some of Fini has to switch up.
It's a scarf. You think it's a scarf. We all think it's a scarf, but is it a scarf?
Yeah, well, you did outspeed Katana.
Yeah, that's true.
So, top of Fini has to switch out, but I think it pretty much lets Zendrus do whatever he wants. So, I think both player, I think Xiao Teng is slowly deciding what to consider in his game, because Tyranitar's up on the field, you can't simply dish out.
If he has superpower, he can definitely get with a Tyranitar distance.
Yes, if he has superpower, he will have used it. So, I think. Yeah, very much. Well, there's Ace of Switches out, of course.
Yeah, he just has into Landora.
No, into Tapu Fini. Not in a good position.
Yeah, not so good. Not free earthquake, man.
Yeah, not, and that. Oh, they put your protects. Of course.
Okay.
Tapu Fini doesn't want to stand in front of a Zapdos too much longer. He goes for a U turn.
Interesting choice.
He tries to perhaps catch anyone. Trying to gain momentum by switching in and out.
But what would he gain, though?
Well, perhaps he can switch into Incineroar, maybe. For more fake out. But then again, you can't really do much against Tyranitar, right?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Because right now Tyranitar is posing quite a big threat against Xiao Teng's team.
Yeah, of course if Incineroar actually has a low kick, then the Tyranitar will be a big bind here.
A bit of a bind, true.
So
Flare Blades, Fake Out, Darkest Lariat and Protect maybe?
Yeah, but of course the longer that Xiao Teng tries to switching around, he actually loses momentum as he switches out. Now he's Incineroar is taking a lot, he's been taking more damage as he tried to gain momentum.
Yeah, correct. So here, I really think that Xiao Teng is just making a few unnecessary. He needs to be more offensive.
Yeah, he needs to go on the offense right now. Goes for Tailwind play. Well, not sure if the Thunderbolt.
Okay. I mean, he's already faster.
Yeah, perhaps he's trying to. No. Maybe he's trying to leave the Tyranitar alone from what I
What's
see.
What's the point? It's gonna take too much damage.
But you can't simply attack a Tyranitar.
But you just need to nuke it down, like ASAP.
Yeah. Of course, if Xiao Teng doesn't have any super effective, any nuke attacks that takes on Tyranitar is gonna be a problem. And, well, at this point, Fini can.
I mean, if you don't damage it, it's just gonna run free like this.
Yeah, and you're just giving Tyranitar more opportunity to dish out damage.
Yeah, correct. And Tyranitar is no slouch in attacking, man.
Yeah, it's no slouch. It's one of the pseudo legends on par with his monstrous attack stats.
Monstrous attack and like good stats all around actually.
Yeah, he has a good stats even with the low base speed, but it can be easily compensated with Dragon Dance.
Correct, yeah.
Yeah, so he switches to Landorus. Perhaps he doesn't think that Incineroar isn't doing much or much. But Tapu Fini can just easily go for free body water.
Yes, right.
Great. Is he switching to Aegis Slash? So well, it is still a good turn of events for Xiao Teng. Both Aegis Slash and Tyranitar doesn't like to take Rock Slide very well. Oh, and
Zapdos actually avoids the Rock Slide.
I think that's very important.
It's quite big.
Yeah, any damage on Zapdos is very valuable. So
because he knows that, JSDO knows that Xiao Teng's Zapdos is like the key to beating him.
Yes, it's one of the keys. So as long as he takes down the Zapdos, he can pretty much get over with the game. But Tyranitar goes for a protect. A little questionable play. Oh, double protect.
I guess they're starting out Tailwind right now.
But Tailwind I guess he's trying to stop Tailwind, but Earthquake comes. There's an Earthquake. So
it's a fair Earthquake.
Yeah, I think he just wants to get as much damage off as he can.
Yeah, he needs to take out the Tyranitar ASAP.
Yeah, perhaps Duo's trying to scout whatever Xiao Teng's trying to do, and maybe do some switches again later on.
Could be a possibility. Right now, Aegis Slash is in alright position.
Yeah,
I mean, if he has White Guard, now's the time for it to use it.
Yeah, if he has a White Guard, of course, we're not sure what. See, he has Substitute, so yeah. King Shield.
So, Substitute and like shown that he's got Sacred Salt, so it's possible that he doesn't have it.
Yeah, it could be a big possibility, and it goes for an Earthquake. So, doing a massive amount of damage.
Gonna launch it up.
It
could be a double.
It was a critical hit.
Oh, no, okay, it's not a crit on Aegis Slash, but holy crap.
Yeah, lot.
Tyranitar. I think it wouldn't have mattered if he went for a Thunderbolt into the.
Yeah, if he. Oh, I think he goes for Hidden Power, trying to catch Landorus switch in. But now I think with this double knockout, I think Shouting is in a bad commanding position.
That crit onto JSDO's Taranita, yes. Really.
Had a
knocked it on the ball, yeah. Fight, honestly.
Had a Taranita survived, perhaps a rock slide after a previous policy boost could be able to take it out with the Zapdos.
So, true.
Yeah, now we'll see Katana and Fini on the field, which I don't think they like to take. Dio has to stall around for another turn or two for the tailwind.
No, tailwind's over already.
Has it over? Okay.
It's over already, but now it's like there's nothing that the Tapu Fini can do against the Zapdos. Against both Pokemon. I mean, it can launch up a Muddy Water, but
I think
if Zapdos drops a
Thunderbolt,
a fat Thunderbolt, the Fini.
Perhaps a Landorus Earthquake might be able to KO it at that range.
Here, Earthquake Thunderbolt, man.
Yeah,
wait for a Leaf Blade.
Leaf Blade, okay. Early Blade, well.
Fishing for crits, I guess.
Yeah, but it doesn't really matter. Zapdos excellent typing actually makes it.
Landorus actually going for it, so revealing actually choice back.
Thanks, whoa.
Okay.
I think it's okay for Shouting because he just needs to play it slowly.
Back, yeah.
Yeah, he can play this whole game slowly. And he got a tailwind up, so I think that pretty much matters.
Maybe Thunderbolt would be the best.
Yeah, if Thunderbolt would be good, but I think there's no reason for him to play in a risky manner.
True.
So now, Landorus is still alive, but he's still.
I see what's gonna happen now.
So Incineroar comes in, and I believe he could be out.
He needs to KO the Fini.
He needs to KO the Fini, but if he goes for an Earthquake, he would hit his own Incineroar.
Exactly.
So we don't know what other boosts Landorus would have.
Yeah, Knock Off, which had U-turn.
Yeah.
And Rock Slide, I guess.
Yep.
Rock Slide is obvious. Maybe even Rock Tomb, who knows?
Yeah.
We have not seen it being revealed.
Yep, we haven't seen Rock. Of course, now, since Fini was revealed to be Specs, he couldn't Protect, so that was pretty much a free hit on the slot. So Katana
actually going for Protect, very safe Protect.
Yeah, very safe attack. He can't really stay long on the field. Yep, he has to go for it, but we don't know what would. Oh, he actually goes for Earthquake.
Actually, he's gonna just go ahead and sack his
General,
because I think like now it's not can't really serve much of a purpose.
Yeah, he can't really serve much of a purpose, but of course it depends what is the fourth one at the back that Shouting can actually use to deal with Katana.
Could be Metagross, at least it does damage.
Yeah, at least it does a sizable amount of damage. Of course,
is it Fini?
But if it adds a Fini, that could be a problem.
It is Fini.
Oh, it is Fini.
But we know it's Scarfed.
Yeah. But
the question is, what will it go for?
Yes. Of course, if Katana actually knocks out the Fini, then
not currently because of the tailwind.
Yeah, that's the.
It protected the last turn, so now it's really, really exposed.
Yes. Then again, even without tailwind, Fini is Scarfed. So you can still go.
Fini can easily.
Yeah, you can go for a Moonblast maybe and. Oh, an Ice Beam.
Oh, Ice Beam. This is a rare move you don't see on Fini.
Yep. Fred.
There's
a U-turn. Yeah, it doesn't really matter.
He's just gonna chip for
Not
a KO, but not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all because I think Landorus can still take it down with a U-turn. Wait, no. If the tailwind were to get stalled
out, there's a chance that JSDO might win.
Yeah, if he gets pulled off the double protect.
True, double protect is gonna win.
If he gets a double protect, he will win this game.
He's gonna try to stall it out, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, he has
like
to stall.
I said, I didn't think he needed to go for the tailwind, honestly.
Yeah,
the tailwind. If he was cut off, why go for protect then?
Yeah, you'll still be faster anyway, right?
Should have Earthquake, honestly.
Yeah, so tailwind petered out, okay, so that's a bad spot.
Should have thunderbolted into the Fini.
Yep.
Strongly feel that should have been done.
Yeah. The tailwind wouldn't really matter regardless. Any much damage is big damage. Of course, now both players shaking their hand. They're in. I would say both players do very, very well.
They did what they could.
Yeah.
Could have done better, obviously.
Yeah, they could have done better. Of course, Shouting actually planned his endgame quite okay,
but I think the tailwind at the end wasn't the best move. I think if you push it to a 3v1, you can easily win.
Yes, a 3v1 is definitely a more ideal situation. The 3v1 is definitely a more better situation.
Yeah.
So, okay, Shouting goes into the top 4. It's fine, really, because I think both players do it very, very well.
Alright, so we'll be seeing you for the finals. We don't really know, JSDO versus somebody, I guess.
Yeah, find somebody. It could be the winner between Martin and. Yeah, could be Martin and Akio.
We'll be taking a short break and we will be seeing you for the finals of this mid-season showdown. See ya.